You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Yame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word, spoken to me.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
It is Thursday, the 28th of July, 2022, 17th week in ordinary time, and participating in the proclamation of the Word of God for today are the following Daily Bread members. Rosemary Master, who turns 60 tomorrow from Johannesburg, South Africa, takes for us the first reading. Kenneth Mamwadi from Bulawayo, Zimbabwe, who celebrated his birthday yesterday, takes for us the responsorial psalm. And proclaiming the gospel is Father George Omondi, who celebrates his birthday today, a spiritual missionary working in Nairobi, Kenya. Let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
First reading, like the clay in the potter's hand, so you are in my hand. A reading from the book of Jeremiah. Jeremiah 18, 1 to 6. The word came to Jeremiah from the Lord. Arise and go down to the potter's house, and there I will let you hear my words. So I went down to the potter's house, and there he was working at his wheel, and the vessel he was making of clay was spoiled in the potter's hand, and he reworked it into another vessel, as it seemed good to the potter to do. Then the word of the Lord came to me. O house of Israel, can I not do with you as this potter has done, says the Lord? Behold, like the clay in the potter's hand, so are you in my hand, O house of Israel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Taken from Psalm 146, verse 1b to 2, verse 3 to 4, and verse 5 to 6ab. The response is taken from Psalm 146, verse 5a. And the response is, blessed is he who is helped by Jacob's God.
Blessed is he who is helped by Jacob's God.
My soul give praise to the Lord. I will praise the Lord all my life. Sing praise to my God while I live.
Blessed is he who is helped by Jacob's God.
Put no trust in princes, in mortal men who cannot save. Take their breath, they return to the earth, and their plans that day come to nothing.
Blessed is he who is helped by Jacob's God.
Blessed is he who is helped by Jacob's God, whose hope is in the Lord his God, who made the heavens and the earth and seas and all they contain.
Blessed is he who is helped by Jacob's God.
They sorted the good vessels, but threw away the bad. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Matthew chapter 13, verses 47 to 53. At that time, Jesus said to the crowds, "Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net which was thrown into the sea and gathered fish of every kind. When it was full, men drew it ashore and sat down and sorted the good into vessels, but threw away the bad. So it will be at the close of the age. The angels will come out and separate the evil from the righteous and throw them into the furnace of fire, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth." "Have you understood all this?" they say to him. "Yes." And he said to them, "Therefore, every scribe who has been trained for the kingdom of heaven is like a householder who brings out of his treasure what is new and what is old." And when Jesus had finished these parables, he went away from there. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
This is one of my favorite passages in the book of Prophet Jeremiah. Jeremiah is told to go down to the potter's house, and there God was going to let him hear his word. He went down to the potter's house, and what did he notice? He noticed the vessel this potter was working on of clay was poured in the potter's hand. It was looking disfigured. He noticed something similar to what is happening in your life. You look disfigured because there is confusion in that relationship. He noticed what is happening in your life because the job you thought was your right job isn't looking like one. He noticed what is happening in your own life with your own health. You seem to think you have reached a dead end. But mind you, the potter knows the clay. And I would like to reflect on this in tonight's good night message. The potter knows the clay. Turn to this passage whenever you find things are in confusion in your life. God is working out something big in your life. I am telling you, and I'm speaking with conviction, because this is what I have seen in my own life. I have seen the power of God at work in my life at a time I thought there was total confusion and nothing was going to move. God worked out something. I don't know the confusion in your life. I don't know what seems to be spoiled in your hand. Understand this, when you seem to be in a certain confusion in your life, you are in the potter's hand. God is making something out of that. And you will soon tell your story. You are going to give that testimony of how God changed things, of how God changed everything. He works in ways we cannot see. And he's going to change a situation you think is impossible. Look at Joseph. When Joseph was thrown into that pit, he looked like spoiled clay. But God had a plan. God was working out something in that confusion. And he became a governor. I know there are many people who are able to tell their story as they listen to this preaching. There are people who are already giving testimony of how God has transformed a disordered condition into something special. And he's going to do that in your life. Please hold on. Don't give up. There is something else coming. There are times when you feel you have reached your dead end. And God comes through to tell you that he knew what he was doing. Even now he's telling you he knows what he's doing. Oh no, but how am I going to pay these bills? How am I going to handle this? Oh no, my husband, a drunkard. Oh, things are terrible. He knows what he's doing. He will work it out. Trust him. Trust the potter who knows the clay. He is designing something special out of that confusion. Maybe you have lost a job. You have lost a spouse. God is designing something special out of that confusion. Hold on. Trust him and he will work it out. The parable Jesus gives in today's gospel explains to us how much patience we are supposed to have in dealing with situations that we find ourselves in. It is a parable of the fish, different kinds of fish. We have different kinds of personalities. We have different kinds of people we live with, and we have to bear with these personalities, these characters, and wait for the harvest. Don't take things in your hands. Allow God to change a situation, not you. We give glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Thursday to you.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me, and I'm desperate for.
This is